Beardsley diagrams are a particularly effective way to represent arguments. Not only do they show us the internal structures of arguments, but they also show us whether premises work dependently or independently to support a given conclusion. To construct an effective Beardsley diagram, it's necessary, first of all, to bracket and number propositions correctly. It turns out that there are a number of common mistakes that students make when doing this. We'll cover a number of these. We'll begin with an example. Animals have rights, so we should not eat them. Furthermore, a vegetarian diet is more healthful than one containing meat. And finally, it takes fewer resources to grow vegetables than to produce meat. If we have a less resource-intensive way to produce our food, we should pursue it. One mistake that students commonly make when numbering and bracketing a passage like this is to include indicator words in the brackets. We see here that propositions 2, 3, and 4 all include indicator words, specifically the words so, furthermore, and finally. Remember that these are, strictly speaking, not parts of the propositions that they introduce, and so they should not be included in brackets. Now, sometimes this can't be adhered to. Sometimes we'll see that indicator words are actually embedded within the middle of propositions, and in those cases, there's really nothing we can do but to include them within the brackets. But if we can exclude them, we do exclude them. Secondly, students sometimes will not number propositions in the order they appear. In particular, there's a temptation sometimes to number the first conclusion number one, as we see here. You shouldn't do that. Simply number the propositions in order. Third, sometimes students will not even include brackets. We see here that all five propositions have been numbered, but because there are no brackets, I can't tell where they're supposed to end. For example, does proposition 1 include the word so? Without the brackets, I can't tell. Next, sometimes numbers are listed after propositions. It's not uncommon for students to do this while also not including brackets. Remember that numbers should always go in front of the propositions. Next, sentences are frequently not broken up properly. Look at proposition number 1. Animals have rights, so we should not eat them. That's not just a proposition. That's an entire inference. It needs to be broken up. The flip side of that is that sometimes students will break up hypothetical or disjunctive propositions improperly and number their parts separately. In this case, we find that proposition 5, if we have a less resource-intensive way to produce our food, we should pursue it, has been broken up and given 2 numbers. Remember, don't do that. Just as we don't break up hypothetical propositions when writing arguments in standard form, so we don't break them up when constructing Beardsley diagrams. Looking then at the proper way to bracket and number this argument, we get, number 1, animals have rights. So, number 2, we should not eat them. Furthermore, 3, a vegetarian diet is more healthful than one containing meat. And finally, 4, it takes fewer resources to grow vegetables than to produce meat. 5, if we have a less resource-intensive way to produce our food, we should pursue it. Once we've bracketed and numbered our propositions, we have to determine whether the premises support the conclusion dependently or independently. Again, let's look at a simple example. 1, I should go to class, because 2, it will help me pass, and 3, I want to ask out one of my classmates. The premise indicator because tells us that propositions 2 and 3 support the conclusion number 1. Now in this example, the premises are clearly independent. They don't have anything to do with one another. If we were to remove proposition 2, it wouldn't affect the strength of the inference from 3 to 1, and vice versa. So that's why we have separate arrows drawn from 2 and 3 to the conclusion. Contrast that with this example. I should go to class because 2, I'm failing, and 3, going will help me pass. Well, proposition 3, leading to proposition 1, presupposes that I'm failing the class. If 2 were removed from the equation, then the strength of the inference from 3 to 1 would really be weakened. That's how it is that propositions 2 and 3 work together to support 1, and so it should be represented that way. bracketing and numbering propositions properly, and determining whether premises work dependently or independently to support conclusions are really the most fundamental skills for constructing effective and correct Beardsley diagrams.